Hello and welcome back to Engineering Online. In this tutorial, we are going to interface a GSM module SIM800A with Arduino Uno. Although several types of GSM modules are available in the market, but we would be using the most popular one, that is SIM800A. Interfacing of GSM module with Arduino Uno is quite simple because we need to make only three connections between GSM module and Arduino board. GSM mainly stands for Global System for Mobile Communication, and it is an international standard. Some available GSM modules are SIM900, SIM800, SIM808 and SIM520. We would be using SIM800A in this video. It can send or receive data over GPRS, send or receive messages and voice calls. To communicate with the PC or any microcontroller, it uses UART. GSM module uses AT commands for its configuration purpose. Here are some of the main specifications of SIM800A, that is, it operates on quad bands, that is 850 MHz, 900 MHz, 1800 MHz and 1900 MHz. Its dimensions are 48 by 50 mm. Its weight is around 40 grams. It is mainly controlled by using AT commands. It needs a voltage supply in the range of 5 to 20 volts. It requires more than 1 ampere current to work efficiently. It has a built-in micro SIM card holder too. There are two status LEDs on it, that is a network LED and ring LED. And its operating temperature ranges from -40°C to 85°C. Let's have a comparison analysis of SIM800 and SIM900 GSM module. SIM800 modules are upgraded version of its previous successful GSM or GPRS module series, that is SIM900. There are multiple sub-versions of each series and each of which cater to a different set of users and applications. There exist multiple versions of these modules, like SIM900 comes in the full form, a quad band SIM900 and dual band version, that is SIM900A and SIM900D. SIM800 also comes in the form of full version quad band SIM800 and stripped down compact size version like SIM800C, SIM800L and SIM800F etc. And every module caters to a different set of application. For example, SIM800C has a Bluetooth on it, SIM800L has an FM on it, SIM800F is pin compatible to SIM900 module, and SIM868 is a dual SIM version with GNSS and a small form factor. Now let's explore SIM800 board in detail and identify all the components. There is a separate SIM card slot and we can place a nano SIM card in it. Then we have a two-channel GSM antenna interface and antenna is connected with it. There are two status LEDs on this board. First one is network LED and second one is ring LED. Then we have an MP1482 high efficiency IC. It also contains an RS232 interface for serial communication. There is a TTL interface. It has six connections like MT, MR, SR, ST, ground and VMCU. You can feed the data directly from GSM module to Arduino if the module is enabled with TTL output pins. Otherwise, you have to convert the RS232 data to TTL using MAX232 IC and feed it to Arduino. Most of the GSM modules in the market are equipped with TTL output pins. There is an XH2.4 power connector to connect external power supply. There are some reserved, reset and voice interfaces too. You can see a large capacity tantalum capacitor on the board. It also contains a reserved space for Bluetooth antenna interface. That was all about its major components. Now moving towards its connection and the connections between both Arduino and GSM board. GSM modules are manufactured by different companies, so they all have different input power supply specifications. You need to double check your GSM module power requirements first. In this tutorial, our GSM module requires a 12 volt input, so we feed it using a 12 volt 1 ampere DC power supply. I have seen some GSM modules which require 15 volts and some other types which needs only 5 volt input. So they differ with their manufacturers. If you are having a 5 volt module, then you can power it directly from Arduino's 5 volt output. So first of all, insert the SIM card to the GSM module and lock it. Now supply power to this module using 12 volt external power supply. Now wait for some time, let's say 1 minute, and see the blinking rate of status LED or network LED. because GSM module will take some time to establish connection with the mobile network. Once the connection is established successfully, the status LED or network LED will blink continuously every 3 seconds. Now connect the ground pin of Arduino and SIM800 board. Here pin 9 and pin 10 are used for the serial communication. The ST pin of TTL interface would be connected to pin 9 of Arduino and SR pin would be connected to pin 10 of Arduino Uno. Now do the same connections on the hardware also. Once the wiring is completed, let's write the software code on Arduino IDE. The main objective of this program is to make a call from the SIM present inside the GSM board, receive a call, send a message, receive a message, redial a call or hook up the call. So we begin by including software serial library into the program. Software serial is a library of Arduino which enables serial data communication through other digital pins of Arduino. The library replicates hardware functions and handles the task of serial communication. So in the next line, we create a constructor of software serial with name myserial and we pass the digital pin numbers as a parameters. The actual format is like software serial, myserial, then receive and then transmit pin. So in our code, pin number 9 will act as RX of Arduino and 10 will act as transmitter of Arduino. Let's get to the configuration part of program inside the setup. The first task is to set the baud rate of software serial library to communicate with GSM module. We achieve this by invoking myserial.begin function. Our second task is to set the baud rate of Arduino's IDE serial monitor. So we do this by invoking serial.begin function. Both should be set at the same baud rate and we use 9600 bits per second here in our tutorial. Serial print ln command is used to print the string of characters on serial monitor. Configuration part is over with setting baud rates and it's good to give a small delay of 100 milliseconds. Now let's get to the actual program inside the loop. To make things simpler, I have developed a user input based program. The program seeks user input via serial monitor of Arduino. If the input is S, the program will invoke function to send an SMS from GSM module. If the user input is R, the program will invoke the function to receive a live SMS from GSM module and display it on the serial monitor of Arduino. If the user input is C, the program will make a call from the SIM present inside the slot to the number added by the user inside the program. If the user input is H, the program will disconnect the call. If the user input is E, the program will redial the same number again. So if the user input is I, the program will invoke the function to receive a live call from GSM module and display it on serial monitor of Arduino. The whole program is simple as that. So before moving ahead, let's learn some built-in basic serial functions. That is serial.available. It checks for any data coming through serial port of Arduino. The function returns the number of bytes available to read from serial buffer. If there is no data available, it returns -1, that is any value less than 0. Serial.read reads all the data available on the serial buffer or incoming serial data and it returns the first byte of incoming serial byte. MySerial.available checks for any data coming from GSM module through the software serial pin 9 and 10. It returns the number of bytes available to read from the software serial port. And it returns a -1 if no data is available to read. MySerial.read reads the incoming data through the software serial port. And Serial.write prints data to serial monitor of Arduino. So the function Serial.write MySerial.read prints the data collected from software serial port to the serial monitor of Arduino. In the next part of the program, we will create individual functions for making call, receiving call, sending messages, receiving message, etc. But before that, we need to have some know-how of AT commands. AT commands are instructions used to control a modem. AT is the abbreviation of attention. Every command line starts with the AT, that is why modem commands are called AT commands. Many of the commands that are used to configure GSM module are ATD, that is dial, ATDL, redial, ATA answer, ATH hook control, and ATO return to online data state. Then we have AT plus CMGF equals 1. This command is used to set the GSM module in the text mode. Then we have AT plus CMGS equals plus YY followed by 10 times X. Here YY would be replaced by the country code and all X would be replaced by the mobile number. When the SMS has been sent, then the end of SMS is identified with control plus Z symbol. The ASCII value of this control plus Z is 26. So we send a character 26 to GSM module. The AT command to receive a live SMS is AT plus CNMI equals 2, 2, 0, 0, 0. Okay, now moving towards the main functions of program. The send message function is the function we created in our Arduino sketch to send an SMS. To send an SMS, we should set our GSM module to the text mode first. This is achieved by sending an AT command, AT plus CMGF equals 1. We send this command by writing this to software serial port. To achieve this, we use the myserial.println function. Myserial.println function mainly writes data to software serial port and will be captured by the GSM module. So after setting the GSM module to text mode, we should write the mobile number to which we shall send the SMS. So this is achieved with the AT command, AT plus CMGS equals plus country code and then followed by the mobile number. Okay, then the next step would be that we should send the actual content of SMS. The end of SMS content is identified with the control plus Z symbol. As we know that ASCII value of the control plus Z is 26, so character 26 would be sent to the GSM module by using the myserial.println character 26 command. Each and every AT command may be followed by the 1 second delay. We must give some time for GSM module to respond properly. Once these commands are sent to GSM module, you shall receive an SMS in the set mobile number. The next one is receive message. This function is used to receive an SMS, a live SMS. The AT command to receive a live SMS is AT plus CNMI equals 2, 2, 0, 0, 0. So we just need to send this command to GSM module and apply a 1 second delay. Once you send this command, try sending an SMS to the SIM card number that is put inside the GSM module, and you will see that SMS that you have sent would be displayed on the Arduino serial monitor. Then we have make call function. This function is used to call any number from the SIM inside the GSM SIM card slot. The AT command used to make a call is ATD followed by a mobile number. Once this command is executed, then the entered mobile number would receive a call from GSM module. The next one is receive call. This function is used to receive a live call from any number. The AT command used to receive a call is ATA, that is answer the call. Then we have redial call. This function is used to redial the same number that have been dialed earlier. ATDL is the command used to serve this purpose. The coding is almost completed. We will compile this program and upload it on the Arduino board. After uploading it, open the serial monitor and enjoy the interfacing of Arduino Uno and GSM module. That was enough for today. Thank you for watching it. I hope you have gained a lot of information about GSM boards and its interfacing with Arduino Uno. Do like this video and let us know about your feedback in the comment section. Subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Thank you.